Alright, we're in my car. Today we're going on a little road trip. We're going to Bullseye Industrial Sales in Middlebury, Indiana. It's about a 3-hour drive from the shop here where I do all my work. I'm going to take a little drive there. We're going to go check out a new pressure tank. So I'm very excited to build a new pressure tank. It's a 10-gallon unit. And we're going there to check it out, probably buy it. Let's go.
This video is sponsored by PCBWay, offering advanced PCB production, ideal for high-end complex PCBs for your industrial equipment. Capabilities include laser drilling, via hole plugging, plated through holes, and vacuum etching for up to 64-layer boards. Click on the Advanced tab on their site for more information. Link below in the description.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber.
The journey to Indiana goes along I-94, which goes from Detroit to Chicago. And what follows is actual recording while I'm driving of what happens. Check it out.
This guy with his potatoes. Oh my gosh. I don't know if you can see that, but that truck has a shit ton of potatoes in it. Sputnik. That's fucking hilarious. Holy shit. And he is delivering his lopsided load of potatoes to some sort of processing place. Oh, he just lost one. There it goes, off into the ditch. Oh my gosh, folks. We are close to a potato disaster here. I can't stand it. Uh-oh, pulling off the road. He doesn't want to lose any more potatoes. Right over there is probably the potato processing facility where Sputnik is going. All right, this is Middlebury. We have arrived in the middle of nowhere. Yeah, there ain't much here. Don't blink, you might miss it.
We have arrived at Bullseye. So we're gonna go inside, we're gonna check it out, see what they have pulled off the shelf for us. We'll probably check out all the other stuff that they have. Let's go.
Wow.
Dang. Anything and everything, huh?
I'm sorry?
Anything and everything.
Pretty much.
Motors. Fuck.
Oh, yeah. Well, they came out of a factory, or could be in a factory somewhere. It could be here.
Oh, look at these things here. Here they are.
Okay, so which one? 146303. It'll be this one here.
All right.
So after a quick inspection of the tank, I do purchase it. It was less than $200, and we're gonna load it into my car and take it back to the shop and convert it into a new pressure tank.
Yes, yeah, little white car.
So check out this kid.
Yeah.
He's getting a ride on the little cart, and he's probably just, you know, helping his dad or whatever. It's the cutest thing, man. Lucky kid. Remember you did that stuff when you were a kid. That's
actually
awesome.
There's a little cargo net here we're gonna throw over it. I think we'll be good. The lid will probably fall off.
I put two of them.
Oh, awesome. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, all loaded up in the vehicle. We'll head back to Detroit on the 3-hour drive home. Oh, first though, we gotta stop at the local supermarket and take a photo or take some videos of the Amish and their horses and buggies. And of course there's shit, and that is on the roads. It's everywhere in Middlebury from the Amish horses.
So you can see, this is the old tank, this is the new tank. We could easily fit that thing inside of here. Let's take a look at this thing.
It's time to actually build something. Thanks for sticking with the video so far. It's been pretty funny. So we're going to use the Sawzall. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to cut the handles off the tank because I don't need those. And this is a very special tank, apparently. It bleeds when you cut it. You'll notice the bleeding there. I'm not really sure. It could be a religious thing. Not sure. Oh, it's bleeding pretty good there. All right, get that handle off of there. Get it out of the way. So the reason I need to cut the handles off is because this is going to be a heated unit, and we've got some heater bands that are going to go around the outside of this thing, and the handles would have prevented me from putting two heater bands on there. So I saw them off, and here I am just grinding away anything that's left so we get a nice clean finish on this, and we got nothing protruding out preventing the heat from penetrating into the tank. I want my tank to have a lid that is connected to the body. I want to be able to swing this lid open and have it connected, because the way I'm going to mount this tank is against the wall horizontally. It is not going to be standing up vertically. So I want to be able to not lose this lid and be able to open and close it very easily. I whipped something up in CAD here so that I can have it fabricated and then welded onto the tank. So a very simple hinge with a pin that goes through it. Originally, I had a bearing, you know, from like a roller skate in there for the hinge, but that didn't work out. We ended up going with some bushings to make the thing work. So this is a quick sketch. This is what I gave to the mechanical engineer who took care of all this stuff. His name is Brandon. Did a fantastic job. Here you can see the section of what we're doing. We got a shaft that runs through the middle and some brass bushings. Here it shows a bearing still, but we ended up going with a press fit brass bushing. And so we need to fab this up. Now, this was not done at my shop. I don't have these capabilities. So this was video that's recorded from Brandon where he works. And they water jet my hinges out of quarter inch material. That's what I spec'd. And so here you can kind of see the water jet cutting out the four pieces of the hinge to get the parts that we need to have this all put together. So for those of you that are not familiar with what water jet cutting is, you are basically using a very high pressure stream of water, usually with some sort of an abrasive, to cut a material, in this case steel. So that water is coming out of that nozzle underneath that red thing so fast that it is able to cut the material, in this case a piece of steel, and that's how things are cut out. Sometimes lasers are used, but in this case they have a water jet and that's what they cut stuff out with. You can see one of the hinges right there. And the abrasive that they use, I think, oftentimes is like a garnet stone. It's a very, very fine powder, but it's a pretty hard material. And that is what actually, in conjunction with the water, cuts the steel. So, for example, like the pickles, the sliced pickles that you have in your refrigerator, those pickles are also cut via a water jet machine. And you always wondered how they slice those pickles up. Well, that's just the same thing as we're doing here with this steel, but pickles. These are the parts all cut out, and we need to drill the hole the correct size, and then ultimately they ream the hole to the exact size before they put the bushing in it. And so this is a reamer on a drill press here, and it's just reaming it out to a very, very specific size so that they can press the bushing in there. We're going to take a look at that next. So that's what the part looks like, all drilled out to the exact size. And then we'll take this over to a press, or they did, and we'll press fit that brass bushing into place. And then that bushing, the collar that sticks out that you see there, goes in between the two hinge parts. There's a shaft in the middle, and there's two clips that clip into the groove to hold it all together. Now, unfortunately, I was not able to get any video of the tank being welded together, and so this is the final result of the lid attached onto the body of the tank. We'll need to make possibly a little bit of adjustments there, but that's as far as we've got on this video. We'll open it up, we'll take a look at it. In the next video, we're gonna cover the rest of this thing, all the mechanical valves and adding the heat and the temperature sensor on the inside and mounting it to the wall. If you like the video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, that really helps me. If you didn't like it, give it a thumbs down twice. Hey, and don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook sometimes, Twitter usually, and now Instagram. Rock on. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.